Good morning, Ms. Bowser.
Good morning.
I welcome you to our Sunday morning worship service. We'll be worshiping here in the sanctuary or at home via electronic means. We welcome to the service. We hope that something you hear, some word from the Lord, some exchange that you have with another person will cause you to be uplifted, encouraged, and give you strength to go through the rest of your life. One of the things that I've done over the last couple of days, few days really, is attend funerals. It's never any fun, but it causes us to stop and think, what are we doing with our lives? We have to ask ourselves that question every now and then, because the answer has to be, we're dedicating and working our lives for His kingdom. And you have to believe that in everything that you do and every day that you live. So as we often like to say, repeat after me, there's a blessing in store.
There's a blessing in store.
For you and for me.
For you and for me.
In the year of our Lord.
In the year of our Lord.
2023.
Hallelujah,
anyway. It'll be good. Many times we stop and ask ourselves, why is it that we pray? What do we pray about and why do we pray? The answer has to be to strengthen that personal relationship that you have with God.
Amen.
Not the one you have with me or somebody else in the congregation. Not the one that you have with your family, your friends, your co-workers. But the personal relationship that you have with God, one-on-one, that's what you have to concentrate on. Sunday school lesson this morning, we talked about King Solomon again and the wisdom that he espoused in his teachings and direction. But we find out something very interesting about King Solomon. He didn't always do what the Lord told him. And as a consequence, he didn't enjoy the full life that he might have because he disobeyed God. So I ask you to look at your personal relationship with God. Look at the things that you do every day. And make sure that what you're doing reflects great on Him and your relationship with Him. Let us pause now for a moment of prayer. Gracious God, we come to you this morning. Humbly as we know how, with our eyes closed, our hands clasped, and our knees bowed. Help us to know, dear Lord, what we must do to keep you not on the fringes of our lives, but at the very center of our existence. Our sins are sometimes too heavy for us to carry. Yes, Father, they are too deep for us to undo. Forgive our lips, tremble to name what our hearts can no longer bear, and what has become for all of us an all-consuming fire of judgment. God, our Father, set us free from a past that we cannot change, and open our spirit and our hearts to a future which can be changed with your help as you lead us along the path to salvation. Grant us the grace to grow more and more in your likeness and your image. Help us, Lord, not only to be hearers of your holy word, but strengthen us spirit makes us small, and we miss the chance to speak from our strength. Sometimes doubt invades our hopefulness, and we degrade our own wisdom. Holy God, we ask you from sunup to sunset to bless us with your grace, your mercy, and your love. In the name of the Holy Trinity, the Father, who holds us tightly in his hand, the Son, that boasts magnificent Negro carpenter from Nazareth, and the Holy Spirit, that lives and dwells in us all. Let us all say amen.
Amen.
Amen. tired and we're going to work on. Some of you will call on a Zoom call. The pastor will be here in the sanctuary. We'll do it in person, Zoom, and by all means necessary to get the word out. But put that on your calendar. Wednesday, the 20th of September at 8 p.m., we'll restart our Bible studies. I know I'm personally looking forward to that. Several of you mentioned it too. Good. We're going to have a retreat at Metropolitan in October, and the purpose of the retreat is to analyze where we are now, where we have come from, and more importantly, look forward to 2024 and where we want to go to for the next 5, 10, 15 years. So I want you to watch the media. There will be announcements up on when it will be. We're working on a location and a time now, but it'll be on Saturday, probably third week. I don't know. We'll let you know. third Saturday in October, but I'm not sure yet. But keep stay tuned for information on the church retreat. And it's not just for board members and officers. Everybody who wants to come, and everybody who's interested in Metropolitan going forward and higher, we want you to plan to be there. We're going to start at 10 o'clock in the morning, feed your lunch, and go along if we need to in the afternoon. All day retreat, plan for it, listen for it. One of the things that we were interested in doing is we've been involved with One Church United. And one of the things that the pastor is interested in is worshiping with the other congregations in our city. Not only necessarily St. Paul, or I'm talking about the white churches. You know, somebody said that the most segregated time in America is 11 o'clock on Sunday morning. And we can't get to where we need to go if we think we can solve our own problems by meeting over here, meeting right there, and meeting over there. We got to come together and work together to better our problem, our community. So stay tuned for that. It's also coming. We're looking forward to a lot of things about this new retreat. So I want you to give it some thought. Where are we now in 2023? Where do we need to go in 2024 and beyond? And more importantly, what is it that you want to play a role in? And raise your hand and we'll go forward from there. Finally, George tells me that Friday the 18th is the last day you can order your Metropolitan t-shirts. And you can't be in the game if you don't have a t-shirt. So see George today as soon as possible and get signed up for your t-shirt. We're going to have a Sunday sometime in the next couple of months, but we're all going to wear our t-shirts for Sunday morning service. So if you don't show up with your t-shirt, the Lord may not bless you. Page 881 in your hymnal. We will go through our apostles. Minister Corey Sapper is a successful businessman who accepted his calling to preach in 2016. He served as part of the ministerial staff at Greater Life Christian Church in Tampa, Florida, where Pastor G. Thompson is the pastor there. Minister Sapper is a proud husband of Shay Sapp and the father of four beautiful children. If there was any way we could describe him, it would be that he is a man saved by grace and has given himself fully to serve in the building of God's kingdom.
Amen.
I think just with that, he has left us in good hands. So the next voice you hear after the hymn of invitation will be Pastor Sal. And I must tell him that before he goes any further, he needs to introduce his family so we can know what's going on out there. So he doesn't get in trouble.
Thank you.
folks morning in the name of Jesus. Good morning.
Good morning.
Metropolitan, how y'all feeling this morning?
Good.
How y'all feeling this morning?
Good.
Chapter 6, verses 2 through 5, and I'll be reading from the NIV version. Joshua chapter 6, verses 2 through 5, and have us say amen.
Amen.
Amen. It says, "Then the Lord said to Joshua, see, I have delivered Jericho into your hands, along with its king and its fighting men. So march around the city once with all the armed men. Do it for 6 days. Have 7 priests carry trumpets of ram horns in front of the ark. And on the seventh day, march around the city 7 times with the priests blowing the trumpets. When you hear them sound a long blast on the trumpets, have the whole army give a loud shout, and then the wall of the city will collapse, and the army will go up, everyone straight in."
Amen.
May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of the word.
Amen.
Father God, in the name of Jesus, God, thank you this morning for just bringing us all together, God. We're thanking God for just having your presence here, because your word says when 2 or 3 are gathered in your name, you are also in the midst. So we thank you for being here this morning, God. We welcome your presence. We usher in your presence this morning, God. Decrease me, God. And so the only thing they see this morning is you, God. Only thing they hear this morning is you, God. Only thing they feel this morning is you, God. Do this for us this morning, God, and we will not fail to give you name all the glory, honor, and the praise. It's in Jesus' name I thank you. Amen.
Amen.
May we see you. So this morning, I want you to know that it's all in God's plan.
Amen.
It's all in God's plan. So I'm going to try to talk to you this morning. I'm not going to try to coop and holler all over the place. So if I do, y'all forgive me, because that's the Lord doing this thing. Okay?
Amen.
So the city of Jericho, it has some issues in architect. When you think about Jericho and how it was constructed, it was 11 feet high. It was 14 feet wide, and it was made all of stone. Amen?
Amen.
And then at the top of that wall, the top of that structure, there was a smooth stone slope that went up 35 degrees for 35 feet. So, and that joined another massive stone that was towering even higher, okay? So when you think about Jericho, when you think about this construction of the city, it looked like it was virtually indestructible. It was virtually impenetrable when you looked at it from the outside in, right? To me, that seems like a lot what we go through. When we look at our problems, we seem like they're too hard to overcome. It's too impossible to break through. Amen?
Amen.
When I look at my credit report, I'm gonna talk about me this morning. I don't know if y'all, I'm going to make sure this relates to me. When I look at my credit report, sometimes I can seem like it's impossible to break through where I'm trying to get. When I look at my job and where I'm trying to go, it seems like it's impossible to get a raise, impossible to get to that next level. It's like I'm always hitting that glass ceiling. It's like I've been working hard to get in shape. I can't seem to lose this belt this morning. I'm working on it, right? But I can't seem to get the results I'm looking for, because that Jericho that's standing in front of me seems impossible to get. It seems impossible to break down. Amen?
Amen.
So God, I look at some things and I feel like, how am I going to win this morning? How am I going to defeat this Jericho? And this looks like a lot of the Jerichos we go through. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So God says he's going to deliver Jericho into my hands. But I'm looking at my hands, and my hands don't seem like I can defeat Jericho. My mind don't feel like I can defeat Jericho. It don't feel like everything I'm doing this morning is going to make it way through. Does anybody else feel like that?
Amen.
Do y'all go through things like that in your life?
Amen.
Well, let me go a little bit deeper. Because the strategy that God gave didn't help me. When I'm reading the text, right, it didn't help me. He says that God is going to deliver Jericho into my hands. What's so unique about the strategy is God actually gave the strategy. God himself gave the strategy. And then what's second about it, like I said, on the surface, it seems undoable. God simply told Joshua to have the people march around the city for 6 days, and then on the seventh day, march around seven times. And then after the seventh day, then the Lord wanted the people to shout and attack. So wait a minute. God wants me to march around the city for 6 days, right? And then seven times on the seventh day. I can't even exercise that one. So you want me to march around not a basketball court, not a football field, not a suburb. You only march around the city alone. You only march around the city seven times on 7 days, on the seventh day, and then attack. Oh, I'm tired thinking about that. Okay, let me get back my train of thought. So God wanted Joshua to have people march silently around the city of Jericho. And I have to assume he said silently because they don't shout until the seventh day, after the seventh time. So, sounds like a lot would be going through. You want to shout right now, but the Lord is telling you to wait. You want to praise your way through your problems, but God is saying, nah, do it my way. God wants you to be intentional about everything he wants you to do. God wants you to be resolute in what he's telling you, so he's telling you to be silent. He's telling you to march. He's telling you when to shout. But if he ain't telling you that, you got to do what he's telling you to do. What he tells you to do. Amen. So let's go a little bit deeper and find out how we can get to the situation, right? So how did the Israelites get here? The Israelites got here because Pharaoh was slain. Mm-hmm. Right? And then but God promised them a land flowing with milk and honey. Years before they was even slain. Deuteronomy 6:3 says, "Hear, Israel, and be careful to obey so that it may go well with you, and that you may increase greatly in the land flowing with milk and honey, just as the Lord your God has promised you and your ancestors." He promised this to them before it even happened, but they're in slavery. Then God sent Moses to free the people from Egypt. Then Moses led the people out of Egypt and established the law. But people didn't want to obey the law. So what happens? They spend 40 years wandering in the wilderness. Then Moses died. Then Joshua was appointed by God to succeed Moses. And then Joshua to lead people out of the wilderness. And then their first goal is to win the city of Canaan, the land of Canaan. So they had to win a city that God already promised them. They had to win a city that God already promised them. That means the land wasn't theirs yet. And their first challenge was Jericho. So this is what I understand thus far. Even though their challenge was to win the land of Canaan beginning with Jericho, it was an unfair fight. The fight was unfair because God already gave them the city. And their job was to march around the walls. Amen? So the Lord is saying to you this morning that when you follow God's commandment by faith, the walls of Jericho will come down in your life.
Amen.
Joshua 6:20 says, "When the trumpet sounded, the army shouted, and the sound of the trumpet, when the men gave a large shout, the walls collapsed. So everyone charged in, and they took the city." It's time for you to take your city back.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. It's time for you to take your community back. It's time for you to take your household back.
Amen.
It's time for you to get your peace back. Whatever's been blocking you, whatever Jericho you've been going through, it's time to get it back.
Amen.
There's 3 points I want to share with you, and I want you to take from this lesson. The first one is to believe in this plan.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Right.
So even when God's commands or his plans seem undoable, it brings victory.
Yeah.
When we're faced with seemingly insurmountable odds, we have the ace in our pocket. Amen. So we must learn to be obedient because Jericho victories are won through obedience. They're not won through us doing it our way. They're not won through us trying it our own way. God says in Jeremiah 1 and 5, before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I set you apart. So what basically God is saying is, I already had a plan for you. So just because the plan don't look like the way it's supposed to look right now, it's still my plan. Just because it's not going the way you want it to go, don't mean it's not God's plan. Amen? His command does not hurt us. They're only here to bless us and to make us better. So John 5:3 says, in fact, this is the love of God to keep his commandments, and his commandments are not burdensome. So, no matter what you feel like this morning, no matter what you're going through, his commandments are not burdensome. No matter how bad that Jericho looks right now, it's not impossible. Everything is possible. Everything is possible. Amen. So, Joshua 8:24 says, he did this so all the people on earth might know that the hand of the Lord is powerful. So I stopped by to tell you this morning that your plan, if you're doing it by yourself without God, won't work. If you're doing it without God, it won't work. Because it might look like it's working right now, but it's not God's plan. Obedience is much better than sacrifice. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Jeremiah 29:11 says, for I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans for you to prosper.
Yeah. Yeah.
So believe in his plan and stand on his word. Amen.
Yeah.
The second point I want to share with you is trust in his plan.
Amen.
So one thing I know about my God is he is not natural. He is supernatural.
Yeah.
When the walls of Jericho collapsed, they fell instantly. They collapsed by the sheer power of God. They didn't collapse just by us doing anything. God made those walls collapse. Amen.
Amen.
So this shows us that God means what he says, and he says what he means, and what he says is going to go. So he tells you to march, march.
Amen.
He tells you to shout, shout.
Right.
He tells you to pray, pray.
Amen.
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 Hebrews 4:12 says, For the word of God is alive and active. I'm paraphrasing right there. But the word of God is active and alive because he breathes life into it. And we are God's children. Amen?
Amen.
So that means that his word is active because through us each and every day, we should be moving with purpose, having being in everything we do towards God and for God.
Amen.
Psalms 23 says, even though I walk through the valley, 23 and 4 says, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. So the only thing you need to do is be right. And I love this because in Matthew 9:22 it says, Jesus saw her and turned and said, take heart, your faith is huge. So understand that God is going to do something for you instantly.
Amen.
Even though it might seem to take forever for you, it's going to be instant for him. Because God is not a man of time. Amen?
Amen.
So I understand this might be a little radical, but I believe that God can heal you just like that.
Amen.
I believe that God can change your circumstances just
yes.
like that.
Yes.
I believe that God can make a way for you
yes.
just like that.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
So I don't praise him. And I don't do this because I see this in word. I do this because I believe this. I understand how to live this. I know that God does things instantly. I know that I can be healed today. I know that I can be changed today.
Yeah.
I know that I can be moved today.
Yeah.
I know that my medical issues can be resolved today.
Yeah.
Amen?
Yeah.
I know that my healing can happen right now.
Yeah.
Because that's the God I serve.
Yeah.
That's the God I believe.
Yeah.
That's the God I love. Amen?
Amen.
So trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding.
Amen?
Amen. In all your ways to acknowledge him, direct your paths.
Amen.
The last point I want to share with you is that his plan will be worth it. Amen?
Amen.
So whatever storm you're going through, whatever battle you're going through, whatever challenge you're facing, God told me today that your storm is passing over. Your storm is passing over. So no matter how it looked yesterday, no matter how it looks today, no matter how it looks this morning, oh my God, God's going to make you stronger. Yeah, so stop thinking about giving up.
Yes. Amen.
If you're thinking about giving up, don't.
All right.
God has already worked it out.
Yes.
Amen.
God has already worked it out.
Yes.
Now, y'all hear me. God has already worked it out.
Yes.
God has already worked it out. Come on, God has already worked it out. God has already worked it out. Yeah, he's already worked it out. burdensome. Don't feel like it's not going to happen. Don't get down on yourself.
Amen. Glory.
Amen.
God, thank you. It's not for you to understand. It's not for you to understand how God's going to do it.
Amen.
It's just for you. It's for you to be there.
Yeah.
And for you to serve, and worship, and praise, and walk. A long time ago, God ain't sitting around 2,000 years ago. God ain't waiting for you Jericho was delivered into the hands of Joshua because he trusted God's plan.
Yes.
God is looking for a way to keep his promises, not only with Jericho and with Joshua, but with you. Amen. He will never leave you. He will never forsake you. What a great way to start a study.
Amen.
The plan will be working because it's God's plan. It's God's purpose. Consecrate yourself, dedicate yourself today, for the Lord will do amazing things for you. Amen.
Amen.
The church of the doors, excuse me, the church of the doors are now open.
Thank you.
of God go with you.